The Halo TV show, it's still a thing. Recently on Halo Waypoint, Kiki Wolfkill, who is the head of transmedia at 4343, announced that the Halo TV show is still a thing. It's actually been like officially announced and will be coming out relatively soon. Now, it's obviously nothing to show for at the moment, but it's announced. It's a thing. It's happening. Like, it's actually happening. Not like how it was back in 2013.
I'm thrilled to announce a live-action Halo television series.
Yeah, that announcement happened 5 years ago, and we haven't really heard much about it. I did make a video about this a couple months ago, showing how Halo's TV show is still a thing. It's not dead. It's just I've had the troubles getting the right people lined up. I'm sure the timing of everything needs to be just right as well. And it looks like they're getting the right people lined up. Steven Spielberg is involved with this a little bit. I don't know exactly how much. Nothing's really said about it. Maybe it's just his production team or something along those lines. But then you also have Rupert Wyatt, who is in Rise of the Planet of the Apes. And you also have, for writing a bit of the action, and you also have Kyle Killian, who is from Lone Star, who would probably be writing a little bit more about the interconnected story of the characters. So now I'm sure you've probably seen or read about the announcement of this thing. Yes, it's pretty freaking cool, but obviously there's a lot that could go wrong with this. Video games and TV slash movie media have not melded well. At all. Most recent example being the Assassin's Creed movie. I never saw it, but I've only heard absolutely awful things about it. With the fans of Rotten Tomatoes giving the movie a 19% out of 100, so yeah, it's pretty bad. The only somewhat successful movie series I've seen has been Resident Evil, but that really has nothing to do with the Resident Evil games. So in this video, I'm gonna give you the top 5 things I think this show needs to do to be somewhat of a success, and how I actually do believe that this announcement does tie into a bit of Halo Infinite and its potential release date. So let's get right into the list here. So number one thing that this show needs to do to be a success is to include the Master Chief. Now, I do know that there are tons of external references and books and other media of Halo that tell great stories not involving Master Chief at all. Though, I think when you say you have a Halo TV show and you have the Halo video games, what do you expect to do? You expect to play as Master Chief when you're playing the games. I would expect to watch Master Chief in the Halo TV show, which is actually kind of a little difficult, which because this leads into my number two point right here, is that you need to build, number two here, you need to build up other characters within the show, much like how Game of Thrones or Walking Dead does. Mainly because I'd say Master Chief is not the most compelling character. Obviously, like, he's an important role, but he's more of a catalyst or an audience surrogate to the show, where he kind of plays a role as the viewer, and you know, he helps progress the story through. But Master Chief really isn't that compelling of a character, and so you need to have him more as a, like I said, an audience surrogate who kind of helps answer questions of the audience, or also build up the characters around him, like Lasky, Cortana, Halsey, maybe even Cap the Keys, if you want to go into that era of Halo. Just like, you need to build up these characters. And I've read The Fall of Reach, which that book does a great job of building up those characters as well as having Master Chief in there. But Master Chief is one of many multiple main characters within that story. It's not all about the Master Chief within that book. And I think that's what you need to do with the Halo TV show. Master Chief obviously needs to play a huge part within the story. There needs to be, which we'll get into my another point later on in this video, saying that he needs to be interconnected with a bunch of other parts of the show. Which leads me into my third point here, that there needs to be a good mix of action and an interconnected story. I'd say obviously there needs to be more action in this show than there does about Game of Thrones, but that's because this is probably going to be, at least I would hope so, an action-based show, much like the games. Game of Thrones, I'd say it's more of a story of interconnected stories of people trying to gain power, and then there is action that kind of builds up to these crescendo moments, which is obviously worked out really well for that show. I'd say for Halo, it needs to be a little bit more action-based, since that's the kind of storytelling that they do within the video games and also within the books as well. Also, maybe keep it a little bit more fun and not so serious. It's like a Breaking Bad or a Walking Dead or like a Game of Thrones. Have a little more fun with it, I'd say, just because I think it kind of the story of Halo and the way they choose their storytelling within this franchise kind of lends to that a little bit more. And I do feel that this show for number four needs to do a really good thing of showing Earth within the show and also having exotic environments. I believe having Earth in the show will help kind of root this the show in reality. I've always felt like Halo has always had a sense of reality when presenting their stories within the games. Though obviously they're going off to like these crazy fantastical environments and new people and alien races and stuff like that, but I've always felt like it's been rooted in reality, and they've always kind of designed their art and their environments as a sense of, you know, Earth-like kind of feel, or nothing too crazy, I guess. An average viewer won't really care much about, oh, they'll just blow up a ring, there's another Halo ring, or there's always another planet, but Earth holds something special to humans, and that I feel that this will help kind of root the show in reality a little bit. And for number five, I feel like this show needs to release within a window or time frame of a major Halo game release. You have to ride that hype train, because if the show just came out now, it would be such a small growth, if it even is one, to where it probably wouldn't come to much. But obviously when you're releasing a Halo game, that's when your peak interest within the franchise is at that moment. I feel like that's what they tried to do when they had originally announced the TV show back in 2013. I have a feeling they were hoping to release this in 2014, right, or 2015, ride the hype of the Halo franchise. You know, because obviously whenever a game releases, that's when the most amount of engine searches happen, with least, especially within Google. So could this announcement hint towards a potential release date for Halo Infinite? Way speculating, but I have some reasons why I believe this could be a possible connection. Now, Kiki Wolfkill does mention that this show is going to begin production in 2019. Doesn't say exactly when, but they say it will happen next year. Now, my hope is that it will begin in the early part of 2019, so then this would possibly release within the same time frame of Halo Infinite. Now, I know it sounds a bit of a reach, but I did some research about this, at least the show The Walking Dead, to show you what I'm talking about here. So the show The Walking Dead was announced that they were going to make a show of this back in January 2010. The pilot began production in May 2010, so just a few months afterwards. And then AMC had ordered another 6 episodes. They filmed those remaining episodes in June of 2010, ultimately with the first episode being released on October 31st of 2010. So within a 1-year turnaround, you can go from being announced to being on television. Now, I feel like if you're going to make a TV show about Halo, you need to release it within the time frame of an actual game, because that's when the interest within the series is going to be at its peak. And so I would just have to think that Halo Infinite would have to release maybe in 2019, which would be my initial guess. Obviously, nothing has been confirmed yet, but I feel that with production of the show beginning in 2019, hopefully early 2019, then releasing maybe like in November of 2019 as well, that would make sense for the game to also come out around the same time as well. Though if the show comes out in 2020, that would be fine as well, because if the game also releases in 2020, that it'll be a fine thing as well, because these two releases need to correlate for them to be ultimately successful. So let me know in the comment section down below what you guys want to see in the Halo TV show. I do read all the comments and try to reply to most of them as well. Now, before I sign off on this video, I just want to touch base with you guys on the last video I created. It was about if Marty O'Donnell is coming back to influencing Halo music in some way or another. I do feel like I might have jumped the gun a little bit on that one. I did see that a few people within the Halo community as well noticed this a little bit as well. That apparently Marty O'Donnell is not working within Microsoft, so it could have just been old friends meeting back up and talking about whatever kind of thing. I still hold out hope that Marty O'Donnell has something to do with Halo. I just feel like his tweets are a little too leading to really just say, oh, they're just nothing. I even saw another news outlets cover the same story as well, so I thought it was something just okay to talk about, something to jump in and give my thoughts on. And a few people, actually notable people within the Halo community, kind of called me out on this video, saying I'm being a little clickbaity or just trying to mislead people, making fake news. And You know, they do have the right to say that, and I do appreciate their feedback as well, because, you know, obviously it's being someone like content like I like to make, it's something that's kind of, you know, search engine based, and, you know, obviously something that I want to at least provide something to talk about within my videos, but I also want to do it the right way. I don't want to make clickbait, I don't want to make misleading videos, I don't want to make misinforming videos as well. I want to, you know, grow my channel, obviously, but do it in the right way. I don't want to be a laughingstock or somebody who's, you know, maybe not the best example of the Halo community. You know, we're a small, tight group, and, you know, if one of us is a bad apple, then it kind of reflects on all of us, and I don't want to be that. So do I feel like I'm wrong in making that Marty O'Donnell video? No. Do I feel like I messed up? Yes. And I promise to move forward to be much more diligent in my information and be able to, you know, be a respectful member of the Halo community. And with that said, though, I do want to say thank you so much for the incredible support we've been getting on the channel recently. I believe we've gained over like 600 subscribers within like the last 28 days. Like, what? So I want to say thank you to everyone who's come by the channel, new and old. You're all, you know, it's kind of crazy how this is probably the most growth I've ever experienced on this channel, and it's the most deadest time, I guess you can call it, of Halo information or Halo content. It's also led to the most growth I've ever experienced on the channel, so I just want to say thank you to everyone who's come by, check out the videos, click likes, you know, click subscribe, or just click to watch. You know, I really do appreciate it, and it's been relatively positive support as well. So I just want to say thank you, the viewer, for that, because without you guys, I would have way less motivation to do this. Obviously, making Halo content is a passion of mine. That's why I do it in the first place. But having you guys' feedback and, you know, showing that you guys are enjoying the content keeps me motivated and wants to stay on top of everything involving Halo. So I just want to say thank you very much for all your support, all your, you know, attention to the channel, and hope hopefully you stick around and we enjoy the road to Halo Infinite and everything else past that as well. So thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.